The views and comments expressed on the following radio program by its hosts and their guests do not necessarily reflect the views of RMCOnAir.com or its affiliates. Listener discretion is advised.
In the building. I know y'all all out there voting, about to have wrecks and all that, trying to vote for Trump and Hillary, but I need y'all to vote for Screaming Bossy and my guest in here today, Chef Milton. He's going to be on a hot cable channel this week, Hot Big Networks, and he's going for the world's greatest chef in the world. Hey, y'all. Hot show today. I'm turned up off alkaline juice, and we're going to keep it moving. RMC on air, 323-965-1600. 323-965-1600. Give us a call. Let us know your favorite foods. Let us know if you need somebody to cook at your next wedding, your next baby birthday party, your next baby shower. Any event you have, the chef here today is going to be able to cover any of your needs. I don't care if it's for the next big, next celebrity basketball game. You feel me? Next Laker game, next Lakers party, whatever y'all need. We got Chef Milton in the building, y'all. That's why I'm selling Chef Milton. He paying me big for this, y'all. So we're going to actually get to our JG says. My man Brian, we got to give a... hand clap for Supreme. He's not here today, but we're going to still clap for him. Supreme out working at the Lakers game. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so he
Lakers
would not be here with us today. I had me some coffee, so I got my energy all turned up. And we got my man DJ Khaled. Khaled, I like saying DJ Khaled, but DJ Caliber in the building. Let's give him a hand clap.
Yeah.
You feel me? And we got my man Matt Brown, a.k.a. Kev, on the 1-2-3s engineering also. That's not the 1-2s. That's on the screws that ain't loose. So, anyways, y'all, first thing I wanted to mention was Curtis Blow. Got to definitely give a salute to our legendary from what I had noticed that Curtis Blow, look, I'm looking on the thing, y'all. Curtis Blow was rescued by some police officers, they say. It says Poplar's 1980s rapper Curtis Blow praised police for saving his life at a bus stop after the entertainer collapsed on October 29th. That's what Ted reported. So basically, we just want to send our prayers out to Curtis Blow. That's all I wanted to really do. You know what I'm saying? Salute to Curtis Blow. That's the music I grew up off of. Now you got a bunch of ratchet stuff. You know what I'm saying? So shouts out to Curtis Blow. Other than that, we got our JG says, man. JG, y'all give a hand clap again for my man JG. This is the birthday boy. Okay, Chef Milton is not only here to show the world what he is cooking up. You know what I'm saying? He also is here to bless my man JG with a birthday dinner.
That's right.
Yesterday was JG's
much
birthday. So
much
JG always looking out for me, so I had to pay $1,000 for him today to come in here and cook for JG. So you worth it, JG. I was trying to get a discount, but you know, Milton don't play that. You know what I'm saying?
That's right, Chef Milton. Hell no. That's right.
Before we get into your JG says, let's introduce our guests and bring them in. Let's bring our guests in right quick. Kev, get that for me going. Let's play that track for my guests, y'all. We're going nothing but some good old love music. Take it back to maybe the 80s and the 90s. No ratchet stuff today, y'all. Bossy, I ain't cuss y'all, did I? I ain't cuss yet?
Nope.
Okay, good. I ain't cussing today, y'all. No potty mouth for my watchers is watching. So play that. You got a complaint? Sex you up? I don't hear nothing. Do I hear a plan, Kev? Color Me Bad, I Want to Sex You Up, that's what I'm playing, y'all. Because when y'all get this food, it's like sex, it's addictive, and
orgasm.
Y'all gonna want to sex it up. So this is from Chef Milton in the building. Hey, welcome. Glover Street Way. Hey, I want to sex the food up. Hey, I'm on the sexiest food up. Hey.
The food looks
all right.
Amazing.
Hey, don't it? They don't know nothing about that. Hey, all right, Kev. Thank you for that, baby. Shout out to Chef Milton, y'all. So what's up, Chef?
Oh, not much. Thank you for having me.
How you doing? And then just so you guys know, this is a celebrity chef. He's not like a person be fronting. Because a lot of people be fronting, y'all. And they be exaggerating. And it's okay. You're supposed to, they say fake it till you make it.
Yes.
But this gentleman, I didn't actually go and dig and pull out the pictures with the Mario Van Peebles and all these big celebrities he done been cooking for. He can give us some, you know, history on that, all that good stuff. But I definitely picked up some pictures of that food, though. But he's really, truly a celebrity chef. He's done a lot of great, cooked a lot of great food at a lot of great big events. So, again, we welcome you and thank you so much again.
Thank you.
And thanks to Nakia Brown. Got to give her a shout out.
We
With the Rebuild Your Lab.
Yes.
Out there at the Trust LA.
Yes.
In my neighborhood. I grew up over there on 42nd and Broadway. We was on 43rd. And I actually met Chef. Chef was one of the
vendors.
One of the vendors
for the
out
city.
There.
Yeah.
And as far as that, since I mentioned that, how did you even get involved with that event?
What happened, I am the king of referrals.
Okay.
And that was a referral from another referral.
Okay.
I tell people, my food is not good. It's my personality.
That's right.
That sells
you. There
you
go.
That's
and
right.
And this client, I had cooked for her 3 years ago.
Okay.
And she works for the city.
Oh, wow.
And
oh,
so
wow.
When they were doing a block party, she immediately thought about me.
Hmm.
3 years out of the way.
Wow.
That just gives you a small testament of how good I really am.
That's awesome, because people remember you.
Yes, and so they asked me, could I do it? And it was literally last minute. I was coming out of town from Vegas cooking for a client.
Okay.
I traveled to my clients as well.
Okay.
And so they called me, and they literally were like, hey, I know it's last minute. We can give you this amount of money. Do you think you can do it for 2 hours? And I was like, man, I'm there.
Okay.
And I literally flew in from Vegas. That Friday and that Saturday, I was cooking for about 150 people right then and there.
And everybody was eating that barbecue.
When I saw you and
chicken.
Yeah, barbecue chicken. I did.
Well, barbecue and chicken is what
I did. Yes.
Say.
Yeah, I did barbecue chicken and I did. I did ribs. I did barbecue. I did glazed chicken.
Okay.
And I did baked beans.
Awesome.
And I forgot the other one. It was so much stuff I did.
Okay.
I just know when I got there. I thought it wasn't going to just be, I was going to be other people there eating food. They all came to my line.
Yes.
And
the,
so.
The black food. Yeah, that and you had the Mexican tacos.
Yes.
Everybody get tacos every day.
Yes.
They all over the corner.
Yes. And it was a great experience. And so that just happened. And that's when I ran to you. And
awesome.
I wasn't even supposed to be in the front. I just happened to, that's just my personality to be in front of everybody.
There you go.
To say, hey, how you doing?
There you go.
And that's how I met you. And. We just talked about it. You said, hey, I should have you on the show. I said, yeah, I'll come on out.
Definitely.
And that's when I heard about the birthday boy.
You feel
and
me?
I said, well, I'll bless you
that's
guys
right,
and go ahead and do some food. And
appreciate
that's behind
that.
Me right there, and, waiting for y'all to
and
eat.
And you know what? Before we get to the food, because we're actually going to let him get up and all that good stuff, serve us some food, let DJ Khaled play a mix while he's serving us or something. Let us know, give the world an introduction, because this is the world watching. You know, we on the internet.
Yes.
But, yeah, let the world know and introduce yourself. Like, you know, introduce yourself real quick. Of course, I said Chef Milton
yes.
and all that. Well, I try to speak on you.
Well, no, you did it right. You did it right. You did a beautiful thing. This is Chef Milton. My company is called MDC Concierge, which is basically Million Dollar Catering.
Oh.
And what that stands for, $1 million service at quality prices you can afford.
That's right.
And what I do behind that is basic. I give you what you need, not what you want.
That's right.
Because a lot of people have champagne dreams, but they don't have the budget.
They got a Boone's Farm budget.
So until you can get there, let me make it look the best for you.
That's right.
With the budget that you can afford today,
awesome.
Not tomorrow.
That's right.
And I've been doing it since 2008. And I tell people I don't have a job, so this is what I love. And it's all referrals.
That's right.
That's right.
You put a picture up, Kev, of some of that food. I did like a little collage. That's some. Now, right quick, tell us about that pictures up there. What? I need to see that.
Oh, wow.
I see you made.
Oh, wow. You got some good stuff up there.
Oh, yeah. Well, I was gone. I was so much stuff I couldn't snatch you. See, I put three of them together.
Yeah.
Tell us about some of that right quick.
Okay. Well, the top left, that is my. Actually, that was for a wedding. That was my 50th wedding I secured since 2008. So that was my half milestone.
Oh.
That is, I made grilled ahi tuna, which was marinated in a teriyaki sauce.
Ooh.
And then on top of that, that is a chimichurri sauce.
Mm.
Basically, in layman's terms, people saw this fancy stuff. It's not fancy. All it is some parsley, some cilantro, some lime juice, a little bit of brown sugar, a lot of garlic, pulsed down.
Okay.
I don't know why it's called chimichurri.
Okay.
All
like
I know is it's
fancy,
excellent.
Like
yeah, being fancy.
Fishing.
Yes, but it's excellent. Okay. And it went perfectly on top of the, it was a salty, and then the teriyaki on the grill was a sweet.
Ooh,
so
yes.
It
oh,
hit, man. And that's what got the client, because it was supposed to be eaten as a meal.
Okay.
But they literally just picked it up and bit into
just,
it.
Just like, okay, like it was a little.
And
piece
that's what I knew that, that deal was done. And mm-hmm. so also the other one to the top right,
okay,
that was a grilled chicken
back again.
Sandwich.
Okay.
That was an open-faced grilled chicken sandwich.
Okay.
But that was with red onions, and that's also with that chimichurri sauce. That's
okay.
A very versatile sauce, a simple thing to make. That can go on chicken, fish, but it's originally from steak.
Oh, wow.
Because awesome. It offsets that saltiness of a steak.
Okay.
But I just changed it to my liking. So that was chicken with a sourdough bread I made,
okay.
And then I had cheese, tomatoes, and onions, and it was so big, they said they don't want that as a sandwich, they want it as an appetizer.
Wow.
So that is what they're going to be having for their wedding. And
okay.
That was wow. A slam dunk. And then the bottom one, that's just, you know, one of my favorite foods to make. People ask me, you know, as a master caterer, what is your specialty? I don't have one per se.
Okay.
What I really enjoy doing is breakfast.
Oh, wow.
Oh,
I do
what?
Breakfast.
So that answers my question, because yes. I was going to ask you, what do you have the most fun as far
yeah,
as
breakfast. Breakfast, okay. Because I can do so much, because you could do breakfast for dinner.
Yes, you can. Yes,
yeah.
You
the
can.
End.
Because I like chicken and rice in the morning
yeah, oh,
with some
dude,
eggs.
Yes.
And
see,
some bacon.
That was catfish nuggets, home fries, and eggs.
And I know y'all love that, y'all. 323-965-1600. We taking orders right now. We taking bookings and all of that. You feel me? Chef Milton is the business. JG, you have something you want to ask this gentleman besides kissing his feet for bringing us this food today before you serve us up?
I just want to thank you, you know, for spending the time and, you know, using your heart and, you know, creating the food, man.
Definitely.
I really, deep down from, you know, my heart, I want to say thank you. You
no problem mean? Whatsoever. I
yeah.
One of the things that Bossy had said that I do cook for a lot of celebrities, and I don't talk about it. I am about it.
That's right.
And what happens, I get a lot of it from referrals.
Okay.
And I have clients that will just reach out to me. And plus, I knocked on a lot of doors
okay.
just to do it.
Yeah.
So I get a lot of things happening to me. Because of the stuff that I randomly do for other people.
That's right.
That's right. That's that good karma.
Yeah, real talk.
Exactly.
And
exactly.
I tell people, I don't have money.
Huh.
I have a lot of connections. Hence the name $1 Million Connection.
That's right.
So this is a connection that I may need another day to put out. Oh, by the way, I'm doing this.
Yes.
Can you guys do a shout out for me?
That's right.
I believe in that. And I also
that's
believe
right.
if you have a talent,
that's right.
you don't need money.
Yes.
Because
right.
I learned a long time ago about barter systems.
There you go.
Yeah.
Come on now. There you
that's,
go.
That is what I'm
that's
trying
what
to teach
about.
A lot of these kids.
The
man.
World
go Google that.
Is predicated off of bartering.
Yes.
It goes all the way back. But people take away from and then they feel they're too big because
yes.
people feel that their value and their worth is more than what they really are.
Yes.
So I tell people, if I do a minimally charged for this food right here, just for me to show up, I charge $250.
Okay.
Just to show up anywhere
okay.
I go. That right there, that's about $500 worth of food right there.
Okay.
Wow.
Plus my tax and my gratuity.
I gave you $1,000. I gave you extra $500
yes.
tip.
See? So then on top of that, so that to me, if you were to do something for me, I don't look at the value of the monetary.
Yes.
I look at what can do for me.
Yes.
That's why people mess up this barter system and
yes.
don't know what how to open up doors.
Yes, that is so true. That's what I was saying to him. People, and it stops. It's like the whole point of people not knowing how to work together.
Yeah.
That part.
That's the problem.
That
you know what I'm saying? You get so much further instead of always with your hand out.
I cannot explain. I can't even go and explain to you guys how, well, my building. shout out to Bowers Cleaners.
Okay.
Bowers Cleaners, hold on, I got you, Mr. and Mrs. B. It's 2509 South Central Avenue.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
They own the cleaners. Well, around the corner, they own also a cafe, which is my kitchen.
Oh, wow, okay.
Oh,
and
wow.
I got that
super cool
off of a handshake.
Wow, see that? Being like you said, how do you
that
say
part.
Earlier you mentioned about your personality. You
personality.
Know what I'm saying? It sells. A lot of people's attitudes are so stank,
yes.
And you don't know how to deal with your
yes.
own self. That's
yes.
why you're not going to get nowhere working with people.
Yes.
Have a personality. Don't be so stuck
yes.
up. You know what I'm saying? And people wonder why I talk so much and why I'm so...
I remember back when I was in sales. I'm sorry to cut you off.
Go ahead.
I'm sorry to cut you off. But I remember when I was in sales, my sales trainer taught me that it's not even about what you're selling. It's just... You got to sell yourself.
Mm-hmm.
No, and let me help you out with one more beyond that.
Help me.
This is how I work. I'm an educator.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm a teacher. How can I sell you something if I don't believe in it?
Yes, exactly. You have to believe.
I bought a Porsche years ago.
Okay.
And I went to the dealership. And this is just exactly how my life is.
Okay.
I went in and I started talking to the guy.
Yeah.
What kind of car is it? You know, what's going on? So we're just having random talking. And I asked him, I said, so just randomly, what kind of car do you drive? He said, oh, I drive a Toyota. I walked away.
Okay.
And I said, I said, what do you drive? This dude said he drives a Ford. Walked away. This third guy said, what do you drive? Oh, I drive a Porsche. And I told him, you got 10 minutes to sell me this car.
Hmm.
And I said, what can you tell me the difference between this and this? Because, see, if you drive a Toyota, how can you tell me how a Porsche will handle a curve at 80 miles an hour
if you never
drove one?
That's so
exactly.
true.
I drove Mustangs. Mustangs, I all my life a Mustang dude.
Okay.
But the suspension is horrendous.
Uh-huh.
After 100 miles an hour. Even the Salines, because I had one of those too.
Okay.
Ooh.
Those things are very unstable after 120.
Like, y'all car dudes, y'all connecting right now.
Damn.
But and if you know about Porsches, after a certain mile, they're already low. They drop down.
They drop down.
Oh,
some of the automatic wing comes out.
And it went why? So that drag won't catch it.
Okay. Yep.
See, a Mustang and a Saline can't do that.
Okay.
So how can you explain that to me if you never drove one?
Exactly.
Or not even drove it, haven't had one for yourself.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's how I am with my food and my teaching and what I do. I don't sell you anything.
That's right.
I educate you on what's good for you. Then you tell me what you want.
Okay.
And then I pair it to how my skills will translate to you.
Okay.
That's why I have so many referrals. That is why I am always out of town cooking for clients.
That's right.
Ooh, that's right.
Mario Van Peebles, Melvin Pan Peebles, Dionne Warwick. Those are all the pictures you saw.
Yes, I've seen
all at one time. William Fichtner, the dude that just did the Independence Day movie.
Okay.
Oh,
that
wow.
cat. That was just all like 2 months ago.
Okay.
Wow.
Eva Longoria.
Hmm.
I got
that's
that
right.
one. That was actually
Eva Longoria.
One of my biggest ones.
Okay.
And I'm a master caterer, so when they said... And that's not me being cocky. I really put in a lot of work
and that's
travel.
That's actually the title. The word master is what it is for a reason.
Because
that's not being cocky.
If you don't, and I tell people, oh, what do you, don't take my word for it. My Facebook is open for a reason.
Yes, it
my
is.
Business page is open for a reason. You'll see all genres from food.
Yes, I have.
And I break it all the way down. For Eva Longoria, what sold them, they said, what do you want to taste?
Okay.
She said, well, what can you make? I said, what do you like?
Exactly.
So she said, well, I love ceviche. Well, we're doing that.
Okay.
So then I turned around and said, well, hey, do you like empanadas?
Okay.
She goes,
yes.
Yeah. I said, well, what about shrimp and lobster empanadas?
Mm.
And she was like, I've never had that.
Exactly.
That's my take on
yes.
fusion. That's my
I
spin.
Love that. Yes.
I take the culture and then I translate it to me,
there
and I
go.
Give it back to you.
That's
yeah.
Right.
So I made tilapia ceviche.
Oh, wow.
You
don't even like seafood.
When you see the pictures.
I like tilapia.
You're going to take a bite.
When you saw the pictures, we had to cut the camera because my cameraman, shout out to Lacey. This is my man. I appreciate you. Let everyone look at Lacey. Your company is called LPD Photography.
Okay.
LPD Photography.
He does all photography for Star Studios.
Okay.
I've just been blessed that we worked very well together.
That's right.
He was there. They had to tell all the cameramen to stop taking pictures.
Oh, wow.
Because Eva was eating so much of the ceviche, she said she was looking fat. So I had them in little martini glasses.
Eva Longoria.
Yes.
Wow.
She ate five of them.
Wow.
Chef, I gotta get up to you, man.
Yes.
For real.
So that's the little simple sample things that I love to do to actually wow people.
Okay.
And so it was a hit, and I've worked on that set since because of her. 3 more times since then.
Okay.
So that's why I love doing what I do, educating, because I learn it.
Okay.
Love it. Then I can give it back. So now I can just explain it to you without blinking an eye.
Exactly. Now, I want you to explain to us. I'm up here trying to share your live. I'm sharing his live on my wall quick because my live popped out. What did you cook up for us today? So what do you have for us today cooking up?
Okay. Well, for the birthday boy, he said he wanted something spicy.
Okay.
So, but no fish. But Bossy, you know, kind of overrode that because she was like, wait a minute, I like shrimp.
I like shrimp.
And I'm pretty sure everyone else in here loves
Everybody else in here likes shrimp.
So I said, but that's what makes me so great.
Okay.
So I give the best of both worlds.
That's right. And you did that.
I made chicken jambalaya spicy.
Okay, awesome. Oh,
awesome.
Then I made my infamous pineapple shrimp on a stick. Then, because I had a couple more minutes, I threw together some fried chicken.
Okay. Oh,
there you go.
And that's a double fried chicken, so it's fried twice.
Okay,
it gives an extra crunch.
Okay.
And then I threw together a peach cobbler.
So that was your peach cobbler. You know, I got Bossy cupcakes. Yeah. Y'all have not seen my Bossy cupcakes. So I figured to not override you today with the sweets. JG didn't love them cupcakes they ain't had in a while. So we got peach cobbler. He loves it. You love peach cobbler, right?
Oh, yeah.
So that's why.
Because he hit me when we was at the thing. He was like, man, if you're going to do it. I said, okay, I can bless you with a peach cobbler.
Okay.
Bless you with that. So that's what happened. So
that's right.
Is it okay to get up and
definitely
grab it?
You can go ahead and service. And what we're going to do, we're going to go to a DJ Caliber mix right quick, y'all.
Great.
Thank y'all for tuning in, man. 323-965-1600. Give us a call. Now, let's stick on my TV, y'all. Call it and tell me. Anybody still looking to take Bossy out on a date? You not broke? You're a doctor? You tired of your wife at home? I'm going to take the wives? No, I'm just playing, y'all. I just say something crazy since I'm not going to cuss for y'all today. Tune in, rmconair.com. I know y'all tuned in. And also, YouTube, before we go to this mix, don't forget, always go to RMC On Air YouTube channel. Go check out Global Streetwave, Mac Life Radio. Go check out all the shows. These shows, when we're going live on our Ustream up in here at the RMC, we're going to always be on that replay on that YouTube channel. So right now, what we're going to do, we're going to play some cool, mature music for my guest, Chef Milton, while he get this music, get this food prepared. You know what I'm saying? Everything about energy and spirits. So we're going to keep the love going on up in here and salute the DJ Caliber for this mix, y'all. So let's get the DJ Caliber in this mix, man. What you got for us today, Callie? Let's go to it.
to nothing. For all the people that lived above the building that I was hustling from, that called the police on me when I was just trying to make some money to feed my daughter. And all the niggas in the struggle, you know what I'm saying? It's all good, baby, baby. It was all a dream. I used to read Word Up magazine. Salt and pepper and Heavy D up in the limousine. Hanging pictures on my wall. Every Saturday, Rap Attack, Mr. Magic, Molly Mall. I let my tape rock till my tape pop. Smoking weed and bamboo, sipping on pop stock. Way back when I had the red and black lumberjack with the hat to match. Remember rapping Duke? The hard, you never thought that hip hop would take it this far. Now I'm in the limelight cause I rhyme tight. Time to get paid, blow up like the World Trade. Born sinner, the opposite of a winner. Remember when I used to eat sardines for dinner? Peace to Ron G, Brucey B, Kid Capri, Funk Master Flex, Love Bug, Star Ski. I'm blowing up like you thought I would. Call a crib, same number, same hood. It's all good. And if you don't know, now you know, nigga.
That's it.
Oh, okay.
That was the riff.
Yeah, I can't sing, but I know the riffs.
Yeah.
Y'all, I saw him cuss on this show. Have mercy on him for the shrimp, though. JG is not the seafood. I told him to bring me some shrimp anyway. We're going to have him get to the next year in a second. But real talk, y'all, the shrimp. It got these pineapples on it. Little taste of this heated. Oh my God, y'all. I'm gonna bite it in your face. I wanted to do it to the shrimp. I was gonna have sex with the food. I said it's addicting. That's why we playing love music. I didn't call it love. You have a girlfriend, a woman, a wife?
No girlfriend. No wife.
Women always men.
Yeah.
I think I'm in love. I go with you just so you
can. That's right.
Then I can enjoy some of your money while you make our celebrity meals.
You know that's right, as long as you help clean the dishes.
I'm gonna clean it. I'm gonna clean the dishes, clean your booty and everything.
Oh, well, there it is.
Clean your feet when you're after work.
Look, that shrimp must be really good.
You can get a whole lot of stuff. ain't gonna mention all the other stuff I do for you. Like this. Okay, y'all. This is not exaggeration. I really love shrimp. I didn't even want to eat today because I was waiting to get here. Thank you, DJ Cosby, for that mix. But this shrimp is bomb. Did you eat the shrimp? Did you like it? Don't be lying.
Yes, he did.
Oh, my God. I'm going to make my back tooth, this bad tooth back there start hurting.
Uh-oh.
You know, this damn thing. I need to go to the dentist. Okay, y'all. Anyway, it's too much info. TMI, whatever they call that stuff. So we're going to get back to the celebrity. I'm confused now and a little thrown off. And I got to give my salute to my man, Mr. Morris. I always give my man, Mr. Morris. Give Mr. Morris a hand clap.
Shout out, Mr. Morris.
Mr. Morris is the gentleman that runs this place. Yep. I love him, Mr. Morris. We were supposed to have been going right quick. Oh, but I had to mention this. We kept promoting. Oh, we're going to LA Talk Live. But we didn't go over there. We're going to stay here at the RMC. Well, actually, we wasn't leaving the RMC. But we're going to keep it clean and cut and classy and not be ratchet. But other than that, Big Boy, Oprah Winfrey, Wendy Williams, Charlamagne, KGLH, any of y'all, Kevin Nash, somebody, you know, want to get bossy and put a million into me, some titties in the butt, and get this money. I'm just kidding, y'all. But yeah, I got some family members for the secret place and the people. I'm ready to sell some souls. Holler at me so I can get on a big platform and then bring him back and give him a million for his food. Give him some of that dirty money I done sold people
lives. That's right.
I'm just clowning. So anyway, JG, we got to get to the next meal because of that. But in the midst of me eating this shrimp, what I want you to do right quick, because people didn't get to learn a new Chinese word last week to cuss the people out in the nail shop.
Oh, yeah.
I'm trying to teach my black people Chinese word. Using you. You're not be using you. You're going to use JG. You're going to learn his Chinese words.
For sure.
We're going to make sure they don't be talking about us no dang no more. So y'all better be happy helping y'all out. So we're going to let JG, let's give JG a hand clap for the JG Says, and let's give him a hand clap for the birthday boy. Then I'm going to sing happy birthday song to him when he get back, and we're going to get, no, we're going to say happy birthday when we do the cobbler.
Yes, yes.
We're not supposed to mention what we got yet.
Oh, see, you let everybody
know. They didn't hear me. They didn't hear me. So you're going to do that then. Okay, cool. Help me out. You can help me. You can co-host
me with
that.
I got you.
So JG Says, go on ahead and give us some enlightenment today, JG from China.
All right. The word, the Chinese word of the day is, or the week actually, is gamyan. And that means appreciation. Basically, this I chose this word specifically because, you know, lately, you know, it's been a lot of turmoil. And, you know, I just, you know, I just really been, I guess you could say, fighting my demons. And I just thank God that, you know, I got the people that I have by my side, you know. So I feel, you know, that... not just on Thanksgiving that, you know, we should be appreciating each other, but we should be appreciating each other every day. And gamyan, that's what that means. You know what I mean? That means appreciation, you know. Have appreciation for each other every day, not just on Thanksgiving. Not, you know what I mean? Not just on the holidays or whenever somebody dies. Or whatever the case is, you know, appreciate the ones that your immediate people around you all the time.
You heard it first.
Because you never know, you know what I mean? You never know. And it's like, you know, every year I grow older, every day I grow older, I gain more and more appreciation for, you know, the people that support me that don't even know me, you know?
That's right.
Like Chef Milton right here, you know?
And how are you with me? I'm trying to cut you off. I'm over here having sex with the shrimp. So, but keep going. That's how good it is. But keep going. And appreciation. I ain't going to forget what you were saying. But
yeah,
you just
you
said
know,
it.
I appreciate, you know, like businesses like, you know, Gorilla Print, you know what I mean? Giving me,
we appreciate
know,
the RMC.
Yeah, and the RMC, you know what I mean? Always giving us a home to, you know, speak our voices at, you know. I'm just very grateful for, you know, everybody. And I feel like gamyan, appreciation, that word is very important.
And you just live to see another year. Even though you ain't a black man, you made it past 25.
Yeah, man. Honestly, shoot, man. When I was 16, I told my mama I didn't think I was going to make it. But
oh, you so bad, Jay. I'm getting in the midst of your JG Says. You was that bad, Jay. We still got 30 good minutes almost with our chef. You was that bad, JG. You think
hell
you
yeah,
bad?
I got her house ready
so
twice.
Sweet.
Oh, no.
He seems such a sweet little dude.
That's always the one you got to look out for.
He's my little Chinese angel. I got DJ Charlie's my Mexican angel.
I was a bad boy one time, you know, but I put my mom through so much, you know, I had to stop, you know.
And I got to give a quick shout out, y'all, to Albert. Albert, get in the camera right quick. Go sit down with JG. How about that? Go sit your ass. That means yourself down. First curse word in 33 minutes, y'all. Damn good. First curse word. First curse. I'm about to say another curse word. 36 minutes. Y'all, put the microphone by your mouth, baby. I want to give a salute to Albert, y'all. Right quick, I want to actually do my, before I go back to him, because I was told his live Facebook feed. I'm serious. I'm going to go with Chef.
Thank you, Frank.
You know, I wouldn't be using me for money. I'm going to just use him because I like his personality first.
That's right.
So I can live with him.
That's right.
But then I'm going to super use him for food. I don't have to cook no more. And I ain't going to have to worry about a man trying to make me cook. That's but right. I definitely appreciate him. I'm going to go praise him afterwards. But I want to thank you guys. When you said appreciation, definitely, JG, a lot of people, like we were saying, don't know how to barter, don't know how to work together and all that good stuff. And I was mentioning to actually Chef Milton the other night on the phone. We were talking late, huh?
Yes.
We was vibing and stuff.
Yes, we were.
Huh, baby? So anyway, I'll just let y'all. But yeah, you know, I was just mentioning to Milton about you guys, you know, and even when we were dealing with the brother over there at the other place to do the show at, he even mentioned about you guys, how y'all felt. But I definitely appreciate y'all. And I said for Albert to sit down because Albert's your right-hand man. I love my little Melanie, my little queen over here, my camera lady. You know what I'm saying? All right, camera lady. But I appreciate you guys dearly. You know, if I need to get somewhere, like tonight, we're trying to go out. And Opera like, don't worry. I mean, JG like, don't worry. Opera got you, Miss Ball. Oh, and we straight with getting in too, JG, so you know. Albert, you good. You don't want us to pay. Nobody paying this coming with Global Streetway to get in no club. I went to NAACP Awards and I ain't have to pay a dollar. Right. I interviewed Jesse Smollett. I'm talking about who I interviewed, rappers.
Right.
Why are you talking about what you did? I interviewed Jesse Smollett, Roland Martin, Roland Martin.
Barter our way in there, Ms. Bossy.
Yes, you can.
No, we ain't got a barter. We got it. Nakia got us tonight. But just sitting at the side, I wanted to appreciate y'all. You know, so that was a good one, Jay. I appreciate that one for everybody in Chinese. Say it again in Chinese.
It's called Gam Yen.
Gamyan.
Gamyan. Gamyan. Gamyan. Y'all, how you say y'all?
Huh?
How you say y'all? Y'all got slang in Chinese? Look, they see. That just show you. That just show you black folk.
Gamyan, go away.
Gamyan, go away. I appreciate y'all. How you say it in Spanish, Albert? How you say appreciate in Spanish? You don't even know Mexican.
It's more appreciado.
Apreciate. No, apreciate. He don't even know any Spanish, y'all. That's all that cushion is, Brian.
With Spanish, it's like different words. It's like a...
So how you say appreciate in Spanish since you said
more
it?
Like, apreciación. Like
apreciación.
Yeah. Aprecia.
Aprecia. Yeah. So aprecia. Aprecia to my aprecias. My chicos and my chicas. So thank y'all. And back to Milton again. Yes. Thank him because I ate two more shrimps.
Yes.
While we was coming back. No, seriously, y'all. Them shrimps. I love seafood. They say shrimps is like roaches and scavengers. I don't care. I eat shrimp. But I eat shrimp roaches then.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
And that's a fallacy to that as well.
It's a fallacy to that. Oh, tell me. Because I've been throwing me off from eating them. But
give you a quick education on that. When people say like tilapia and certain
quit
things
that.
Are a scavenger, what that is basically when it's at the sea level. Even pigs, they say, "Oh, pigs is it's bad for you because it's you know it eats crap." There's truth to that,
okay.
But so does everything.
Well, it's air, it's crap in the air, thanks to the government with the chemtrail.
See that too, but just for the fish and chicken, if I had a choice, okay. I'm gonna go farm. Not farm. I'm gonna go fresh because see, farm, they put things in it. To make it look
the tilapia
like
not even a real fish. I just seen it on somebody wall I was on, man. I saw those, I eat the tilapia
don't
at home.
Believe.
And it said it eat
Facebook
pig, boo-boo.
And so does catfish. So does
catfish
flounder.
Catfish is bleed. Like a woman, like me.
Yes. So
you
does
nasty fish.
Flounder.
Do so catfishes does, have attitudes?
You know, obviously I wouldn't know. I
do have attitudes the catfish dudes in the wall. Like, you ain't getting none of that.
Right.
Get away from me. You ain't getting none.
So it's
I'm
so
kicking
many,
it with the girls.
It's so many that you have the issues is like ahi tuna.
Okay.
See, a lot of people think, oh, it's all that stuff eats the stuff at okay. the bottom. Okay. So a shrimp, farm shrimp.
Okay.
You know what they do to make it get red? They put dye in it and they take the pellets of the other shells, grind it in it, and have the shrimp eat it. That's how it turns red.
Oh, wow.
When you're doing the salmon.
You better know your foodology,
this
boy.
Is what I do.
Come on.
And this is why I educate.
And when you do your salmon,
I
go ahead.
Educate
because I need to eat some more food so I can make love to the camera.
See that?
I want to fall in love with you more.
Right, that's right.
I'm already in love.
Well, wait till you taste that.
Finish going with the salmon, though. Okay. Finish your stuff.
Real
we
quick.
We got 20-something minutes.
Farm fresh. Love and connection. They say what is it, farm fresh, and then they say, is it farm fresh or is it salt water or is it
oh,
water?
Yeah, exactly.
If anything, when people, when you have, I call people that aren't, what's the best way to say
it? I want to lick the steak. Oh, Lord. Taste some of the shrimp.
The
again.
Best way to say it, when they're not educated or not informed, they think farm fresh is the best or organic, but they put pellets and they feed it corn, which is why when you look at it, it's a pale pink. When you are in the ocean, it's raw red. When you go to the sushi restaurants, they don't do farm fresh. They do the actual sea because it is raw. And then they have different grades. There's a big difference. It's different grades. But so when people say, oh, dude, like I had a client, Martin Lawrence.
His ex-wife.
I did a birthday party for him. I made sushi.
Yeah.
I made egg drop soup from scratch.
Okay.
And then I made salmon.
Okay.
Well, one of his bougie cronies came and was like, oh, I don't eat certain type of fish. Is this farm fresh or is it farm raised or is it salt water?
Okay.
So I simply said, well, do you know the difference? And everyone stopped like, how dare you? But I already got the check cleared.
Okay. Right.
Doesn't matter to me.
Okay.
Rule number one, if the check clear, I'm going to say what I want.
Right.
So that part.
So where's Mike Lowry?
So they were like, oh, well, she said, and I stopped her because I didn't want to embarrass her. I wanted to educate her, but I also wanted to sort of stop saying things you don't know about.
Exactly.
Just to show out.
Yes.
The difference between farm fresh and salt water is farm fresh, they use pellets and preservatives, and they feed it with corn, which makes it pale.
Okay.
That's
okay.
it.
Okay.
Salt water and sea, yeah, they still eat the same algae and everything, but you still clean them, so it's nothing really wrong with it, except that farm fresh, they're going to charge you $4 to $5 extra.
Okay.
Now, I will give you that, but when I do tastings, I bring them both.
Okay.
And I say, here, try them.
The difference, huh?
And they go, oh, and 7 times out of 10, they go with the salt.
Oh, wow. It's because it's more
fresh. And they don't know. And because of who I am.
It's more fresh, right?
It's more fresh. It has more flavor.
Okay.
So what I do, because I don't have to get over, I'll tell you, see the difference between this one? This is $10.
Okay.
And this one, the one that you want, is $15. And I'll go, oh, well.
Oh, wow.
And yeah, you want to do that times 150 people.
Well, not to change the subject, but speaking of fresh, you looking funky fresh.
Oh, thank you kindly.
Because I liked it. It like we was meant to be. I got orange in my shirt.
Yes, we do. Yes, we do. Let
and
me stop the people see.
Dark, but look, we meant to be. See all those swirls and stuff?
Yes, we are.
So anyways, got my big ass. I mean, oops, that's the second cuss word. Just two cuss words. I got ass ain't even a cuss word. That's the government. That's them pale people got us thinking everything. No offense, Cali's white man. That's some people thinking we just taking all these words, the cuss word. You going to fornicate? It's Sunday. You going to fornication for hell? I'm being nice because of Chef here.
Yeah, that's
back
right.
To y'all, sex hell. Okay, so anyways, before I forget my thought. You looking funky fresh.
Thank you.
I like that jacket.
Thank
and that's
you.
This is actually a chef coat you have on.
Yes.
It's just not just no dashiki.
No.
And no fresh nothing. And it's thick.
Yes.
So where did you get this from? I didn't buy that for you.
Actually, a client by the
What's
name
she look
of.
Like? Who is she?
Look, she's married.
Okay, cool.
And
I ain't jealous.
I did an anniversary brunch for her for her 30th anniversary.
That's so clean.
And she's a seamstress. And she, I was telling her that, you know, I wanted the jacket. And I was telling her about, I wanted something different. I wanted something
she
for
did
me.
That.
And so I said, you know, I want an African chef jacket.
Okay.
I said, because I had to do this BET award show.
Okay.
And I wanted to stand out. So she had said,
that's beautiful.
You know what? I can do something for you. So what? So her name is Lori.
Okay.
And it's from Lori's Design. So
okay.
Shout out Lori.
Shout check Lori's Designs. I spell her Lori.
Lori is L-O-R-I-L-Y-S-D-E-S-I-G-N-S. Facebook.com. And actually what it is, and thank you to Abba Walker for educating me on exactly what this is, because a lot of people, when they see it, they automatically think, including myself, oh, it's a dashiki.
Exactly.
But it's actually not. What this is, it's an Angeline fabric from Ghana, West Africa.
That's awesome.
Really,
that's what, yes, from the motherland.
I ain't got to
go
to Africa. I'm right here with Africa.
See
I'm
that?
I'm at touched Africa.
That is what this is, but it's fully functional.
She saved my bomb. Yes, she didn't go downtown and get you no material.
No. She made this habit.
Like her. Go on, Lori. Lori, what's her name?
Lori Smith Thompson.
Salute to Lori Smith Thompson.
Yes.
For not going downtown Los Angeles to the Fabric District.
Yes.
Getting that good old cheap material.
Yes.
But you went to the motherland.
Yes.
West Africa and looked out for the brother man.
Yes. This jacket was
Let me put my crown on for that now.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Shoot, I don't need my crown on. So, make sure one of my diamonds ain't missing. So now, besides you looking good in that fly coat with your fine self.
It's time for the next.
See, I'm trying to give me a whole bunch. I want breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
That's right.
I might have probably only stroked them enough for a good dinner. I
That's
need it
right.
all. I'm single. My son, 18 now. So now, I wanted to also mention this. I know we talked about how you got started and all that good stuff. We only got like a good 20-something minutes. So 15 minutes. So I don't want to take a whole bunch of time on all that. Literally, you mentioned stuff in the beginning about who you were. But I know about the catering thing.
Yes.
You tell us about the vision, because you had a catering truck, right?
Mm-hmm.
So however you want to go about that route, speak on that right now.
Well, I had a... Well, long story short, because I know y'all hungry, and I know
we
got to feed JG.
Food. Yeah, why it's
so,
hot.
Well, what happened in 2008,
hungry.
How I got into MDC, years ago in 95, I used to own a pager company.
Okay.
Actually, I bought it gambling.
A pager company,
see, JG, you weren't the only one that had the nice smile and was innocent. I used to do some stuff in the street that, had I had now... There's a lot of things I'm glad. The difference is I'm not knocking what I did.
Okay.
But I'm glad that I learned and moved on and didn't go back.
That's right.
Yeah.
So I don't knock anybody
and
for whatever they did.
Do whatever you did, because somebody else did doing what you did. You able to help them.
Exactly.
Prostitutes is prostitutes for a reason. Some people got to smoke crack. Not like that.
Right.
Some people got to be recovered. But keep going. You know, for certain things. It's your story.
What
your
happened,
testimony. Hallelujah.
I went I started working for a timeshare company.
Okay.
Yeah. And... I love it. I love because I love to travel, thanks to my parents.
Okay.
So what happened, I was always cooking.
Okay.
And so what I would do is I would tell my clients that would buy from me, I would say, hey, I tell you what, if you buy this timeshare from
you
me,
buy
I
fry?
True to word. I will go to the resort and I will cook for you and 10 people.
Okay.
Wow.
Breakfast, lunch, and or dinner. And so they'd be like, yeah, right. And I'm like, no, I'm serious. I will go to the resort and I will cook for
you. Okay.
So I would do that and I'm going to get sales and I'm going to get referrals all the time.
Hmm.
December 23rd, we all got put in a room.
Okay.
7,000 all over. They gave us a letter, laid us all off.
Hmm.
Said recession.
Wow.
But the prerequisite was they said they'll give us our, the
stimulus.
Check. Severance check. But the prerequisite is you cannot speak on being laid off.
Okay.
And you have to work until January 31st.
Okay.
That was on December 23rd. December 24th, I get a phone call from an old client 2 years ago. That said, remember when you cooked for us at the resort? No, but okay. And that was going on. And he literally said, hey, we're in Kabul right now. We just fired our chef.
Mm.
They didn't know what they were doing. And we're here for 3 weeks. Do you think you can come out here? Our budget is $15,000.
Oh,
that's what we have left. And we just need you to cook for 50 people a day for 2 weeks. And the last week, you can just do whatever you want to the wedding.
Okay.
Do you think that's something you... I know it's last minute. Do you think you can do it?
Wow.
Well, I thought about it. I really did. So that was the longest 2 seconds of my life. And
that's right.
I was like, because do I leave now or do... Okay. I don't even need clothes. I mean, I'll go to Mexico. I could just get stuff.
Okay.
I'm not worried about it. Don't even worry about nothing. You know, I don't care.
Aubrey Cousins is my one running to Mexico.
So I called up five other people, said, hey, y'all got your passports? They were like, well, yeah. I said, do you want to make $1,000 a week going to Cabo, and the last week we can hang out for free? So they, like me,
okay,
thought about it.
Okay.
And then 2 seconds later,
yeah,
they were like, so when do we leave?
Okay.
So we could, I could not leave because they wouldn't give me a severance.
Okay.
But sometimes, you know, mental stress, you know, yes, you have to go out on stress leave.
Okay.
And there's nothing you can do about that.
Yes.
So stress leave, yeah,
okay,
got me out.
Okay.
And my passport, we flew out there, and I had a check for $9,000,
wow,
waiting on me when I got home.
Okay.
And then I had the leftover money, which is about $5,700 left,
wow,
from the 3 weeks.
Wow.
And that's when I said...
And take that cord off your arm. Finish talking.
I said, that's when I said, I think I can do this for,
okay,
a living.
Huh.
But that's sure not where the chef came in. I took that money, and thanks to my play brother, Bruce, he's an engineer, and we discussed about getting a party bus.
Okay.
But we took it a different level.
Okay.
I bought a shuttle bus.
Okay.
Converted it into a party bus, and I cooked out of the party bus.
Oh, wow.
Oh.
And I had a live DJ. That's what made me different.
Wow.
So not only I had the trilogy effect, you had your music, you had your food, then you had me.
Wow. Well, we need some more food. I need some more of you.
Yes.
We got 9 more minutes. How about that? We can end it with the cobbler and a birthday wish.
Yes.
We're going to get another Cali mix in. We're going to play,
yes,
some more love music for y'all. Caliber mix. Let me stop calling,
yes,
DJ Caliber. It ain't Cali, right? No, don't say that. It's Caliber. It's a Caliber on the internet. Caliber Cleveland. Y'all go check him out. He got beats for sale like they do on the block. No, I'm just playing, y'all. So anyways, DJ Caliber is in the mix again for my man, Chef Milton. Blessing us with the JG happy birthday dinner. We be right back. Y'all check it out. And y'all check this camera out because he's about to show y'all. Oh, hold on. What you got next?
Oh, now we're going to do a double. We're going to do the double fried chicken and the jambalaya.
Hey, bring it on, baby.
And I have to say this really, really quick before I let y'all know. It's not my fault if you guys go to sleep.
Okay.
That's not my issue.
Okay.
I do not hold anybody responsible.
Well, good. We don't got that
no
long.
No eating and
Mr.
driving, eating and sleeping. That's all on y'all because you will have to take a power nap. So.
Okay, well, we ready, y'all.
Like a power plan.
Yes.
Sounds like a power plan, right?
Yes.
I forgot the munchies over there. From the air, the government chemtrails got us all high. We hungry. So we're going to get into that Caliber mix, y'all. We'll be right back. Global Streetway.
Can you let me know right now, please? Bonita Applebaum.
Bonita Applebaum, you gotta put me on. Bonita Applebaum, I said you gotta put me on. Bonita Applebaum, gotta put me on. Bonita Applebaum, I said you gotta put me on. Bonita Applebaum, gotta put me on. Bonita Applebaum, I said.
Bonita, Bonita, Bonita. Hey, Bonita, glad to meet ya. For the kind of stunning you miss, I must beseech ya. Hey, being with you is a top priority. Ain't no need to question the authority. You gotta put me on.
I'm feeling my vibe right now, feel myself.
Panda. Panda. Panda, 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 panda. I got broads in Atlanta. The lean, the family. Credit cards and the scammers. Hitting the licks in the van. Legacies, family. Wait and see, look like a panda. Going out like a Montana. Honey killers on the helmets. Legacies, family. Wait and see, family. Pockets full, Danny. Selling ball, candy. Man on the macho like Randy. The chopper go out to for granted. This nigga full of your bandit. Movie killers on the stand. I got broads in the land. Twisted the lean, the family. Credit cards and the scammers, hitting the licks in the van. Legacy, family, way see, look like a panda. Going out like a Montana, honey killers on the hammers. Legacy, family, way see, family. Package full, Danny, selling ball, candy. Man out the macho like Randy, the chopper go out to for Grammy. This nigga pull up your panda, hope you killers understand it.
You all appreciate it. When I was young, me and my mama had beef, 17 years old, kicked out on the streets. Though back at the time, I never thought I'd see a face. Ain't a woman alive that could take my mama's place. Suspended from school, I'm scared to go home. I was a fool with the big boys breaking all the rules. Shed tears with my baby sister. Over the years, we was poor than other little kids. And even though we had different daddies, the same drama when things went wrong, we blamed mama. I reminisce on the stress I caused. It was hell, hugging on my mama from a jail cell. And who thinking elementary? Hey, I see the penitentiary one day. Running from the police, that's right. Mama catch me, put a whooping to my backside. And even as a crack fiend, mama, you always was a black queen, mama. I finally understand, for a woman it ain't easy trying to raise a man. You always was committed, a poor single mother on welfare. Tell me how you did it, there's no way I can pay you back. But the plan is to show you
that I understand. You are appreciated.
Thank you.
I'm
going to
say one cuss word. Shit! Damn it! Damn it ain't a cuss word. JG, happy now. You digging it, Jay?
Hell
right,
yeah.
Quick.
Is that
50 Cent. I should have asked
fire.
You. Can you pull up 50 Cent?
Fire with a
can
capital
you pull up 50
F.
Cent? It's your birthday.
DJ, how's that?
I'm taking my first bite right now.
Uh oh, there it
Milton,
is.
Milton, right quick. While he pull up this track for me, we got to get out of here, y'all, in around about a minute, really, Mr. Okay. Morris. 3 minutes, 5 minutes. We got to get out of here literally in a few minutes, y'all. So we're going to go out in the JG happy birthday, the cobbler.
Pop cobbler.
Cut up the cobbler for us. While I get the song on,
yes.
But I dang now wanted to ask you a question, so you can't cut up a cobbler. Right quick, you did a contest. I know you mentioned you wasn't a, from MySpace, it was a contest with the Food Network,
uh-huh.
And you won the last 15, gone ahead, yeah. You know what I want to say?
Well,
we was talking, but we had that on.
That's when I really started saying I can make a lot of money in this.
Okay.
MySpace. It was on back in the day.
They had make it quick, we got like literally 3 minutes.
Perfect.
Okay.
They had a contest, said who can make a meal for four people under 15 minutes.
Okay.
I got the submission at 11:30.
Okay.
That day of the deadline. So I was already drinking
I was drinking wine. And so I literally said, okay, let me put something together. I had some fish. So I made some tilapia tacos, rice, beans, with a yogurt and dill and sour cream sauce. Ooh. And I knocked it all out within 12 minutes. Mm. And then I literally said, well, I'm done. So you guys, for the next 3 minutes, can watch me get drunk and look at my dog. And I literally submitted
that show.
And they loved it. And I won. It was a $500 with the chef's knives I got. Beautiful knives. And they literally had said, it's great, but could you do it again without the drinking and the dog?
That was on the Food Network.
Yes.
So, like, I would love to be, because I've been doing radio and TV stuff and all that through the public access now at the RMC. I would love to sit on the seat of a major radio station. Mm-hmm. So I know for you as a chef, you felt honored and appreciated just by probably having the higher powers you pray to. Because that's awesome to be a chef and to go on the Food Network. I love watching the Food Network.
Yep.
So I know that felt super good.
Well, I have another one in the works next year for Bravo.
Okay.
So that's another thing. So it's a lot of stuff that's going on that I just got to stay humble and keep it going.
And stay humble. And the God, universe, Jesus, Buddha, Allah, the aliens, whoever you believe in, Krishna, Buddha, they're going to lead the right people to you. I'm just clowning. I'll be talking
that part. No.
Yep. But no, but real talk. You know, the right people going to stay in your life, you know, and the wrong people going to be moved right out. You know what I'm saying? Because you are definitely already on the road to greatness.
They're
your food
there.
Is bomb.
Thank you.
Super awesome. Thank you. What I'm saying? We got a little barbecue and some chicken, but you to bring them shrimp.
Yeah,
the shrimp costs too much.
If you ever need some water for your
For the event. I wanted to mention, people know where they can find you at.
Oh.
And play the birthday in the background real low for me.
Facebook.com / MDC Concierge LLC. Real simple. MDC. Concierge LLC.
Awesome.
So that's that. And then also, you can find me on Instagram.
And your like page, too. Let them know.
Oh, yeah. Like my Facebook. And then Instagram and Twitter under MDC Catering.
I only want to end this show.
For you. Y-O-U.
Awesome.
That's how you can
now, in the midst, go on ahead.
Hit the peach cobbler.
Now I'm getting in bossy mode. Cut up this peach cobbler before we end out this show.
And you got to.
And we're going to play the 50 Cent. Go shawty, it's your birthday. I'm a freestyler, rap to JG.
Yeah.
I just thought of that. I'm a freestyler, birthday rap to JG. And while he's serving this for us, and we're going to be getting out here in a minute, y'all. Just please, for the birthday, boy, Mr. Morris. I was talking to Mr. Morris. He ain't even here. No, you watching me, Mr. Morris. I love you. All right, y'all. You got the birthday song playing? Because I ain't got the headphones on.
Get a picture of that.
It's playing? Okay. Let's play that 50 Cent.
That's beautiful.
Play that 50. I know. This is instrumental. It don't matter if it is. I'm going to rap with it. You feel me? Hey, Global Street, wait. I can shatter what? Global Street, wait. I can shatter what? Calibre, hey. I can shatter what? Global Street, wait. Hey, JG, it's your birthday. What? JG, it's your birthday. Hey. Screaming boss in the building. Find me in the club. Hey, find me in the club. Club. Find us in the club. Hey. Go, JG, it's your birthday. I know you got your girl, her name is Melanie. And can't none of your hoes out there touch them, cause they on the road and they in the wind. Ayy, flying high like the doves in the sky. JG, that's my boy, and we love to get hot. We stay on the road and we on the globe. And these haters mad cause we won't let go. I got that flow, I ain't really tripping with the freestyle. It's bossy, what? And I like to get buck wild. You bitches mad cause you never can copy my style. I'm Lady Puck in the building and I'm going wild. Ayy, call me the Golden Globe, call me the Golden Girl, call me the Queen of the World. I ain't tripping cause what? It's JG and this girl, they got my back. And this bitch, and I ain't never gonna quit. I'm tight, fuck it, the cussing. I ain't wanna do it. Don't wanna discuss the bullshit, they never do it. And you niggas just be mad, cause it's me and JG. When we ride with Albert on our side, and we don't really trip. Caliber be coming in with the mix, and I really ain't tripping. You get bust in the lip if you stepping out of line. Stay in your lane, it's bossy. Throwing it up for the hood, man. Hey, you can find us in the club. JG Global Streetway, we always showing love. Hey, RMC on air. We don't really care, and I wear my own hair. Hey, don't need no weave, no eyelashes. I'm just getting toasted and getting blasted. It's JG's birthday, and Chef Milton in the building with the food for the children. Hey, 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 what? Hey, y'all, Global Streetway, man. Happy birthday to JG in the building. Thank you for that.
Thank you. I love y'all.
Hey, that was Bossy Freestyle for JG. I was cussing this at the end of the show, so I had to cut. I wanted to make a clean show for Milton right quick. Let's show him this cobbler. We got to get up out of here, y'all. I thank y'all again for tuning in to another Global Streetway session. Hey, now we got the birthday boy. I did the birthday freestyle mix. I'm dropping the juice all over. Call me Peach Cobbler, y'all. This is how we do it. Global Streetway, y'all. Anybody interested, any artists, any entrepreneurs, businessmen, women, all the politicians, Hillary after you win, Donald Trump, y'all reach out to us. GSWMGMT@gmail.com. Go like us on Facebook. Again, MDC. CONCIERGE and Global Streetwave. Screaming Bossy, Alka-Shatter in MLM Media. MLM Media. Go press like, y'all. And Mac Life Radio, man, I always got to give shots out to my engineer in the building. Y'all check him out too on Saturdays, 7:30, right? Hey, happy birthday, JG.
Thank
Milton,
you,
sit down right quick and say good night to your people, man. We out of here.
Good night. I appreciate you guys, and I will see you guys again. Thank you for the opportunity. Appreciate everybody. Definitely give a shout out to my photographer, Lacey, in the back.
And what about the headband? You get him a shout out?
Oh, yes. We got the headband for the MDC.
Where's she at?
I got sponsored by Junk
right
today.
Quick. And we out of here.
So this is the new sponsor that picked me up.
There we go. Put it on.
And it is
salute
pie.
To all the sponsors. We got the Alkaline, yes. The Alka-Shatter water, y'all. All that.
See so, that Alkaline water? And this is my first endorsement. So happy day. Yes.
All right, y'all. Global Street Wave, another hot show, y'all. Thanks again for tuning in. And remember, Chef Milton. Bro. While y'all waiting for a savior, he going to save your tummy. And maybe you some money, because we're about that bartering business.
You, that's right.
You feel me?
Oh,
hey, so we out, boy. Y'all. Global Street Wave in the building.
Oh, my goodness.
Go, JG. It's your birthday.